baby! Yes, America's version of James Bond has returned! And what better place, what more American a place to return than the Super Bowl! And after his spot debuted during the big game, I immediately took to Twitter and I asked what I think is a pertinent question. Is that Jeremy Renner that Matt Damon knocks out with a single blow at the end of the TV spot saying, hashtag, give me back my franchise? I think it is. Obviously, it's not. And someone very cleverly tweeted back, Jeremy Renner's fine. He's going to go and fight the rest of the Avengers and Ultron. So I was like, touche. Everybody's happy. Everybody gets a franchise. Hashtag Oprah. But to celebrate the return of Matt Damon in what has become his signature role, although I would say The Martian is pretty signature at this point too. But anyway, in honor of his return, we're going to do a shot-by-shot analysis of the big game spot. With such close analysis, it'll be worthy of a CIA report. And the CIA, of course, is always looking for Jason Bourne. This is a really fascinating spot, actually, and it shows how much has stayed the same, but also how much the franchise seems to be evolving to match the current political climate that we find ourselves in. But first, I thought it was, you know, really funny that the tagline for this movie is, you know his name, and then Bruno Mars during the halftime show was singing the lyrics, say my name, you know who I am. I was like, wow, what synergy! What big game synergy? I also think before we get started that this is potentially Matt Damon slash Jason Bourne's moment to really, you know, he's already a very popular franchise and the American version to James Bond, but to really reach like legendary movie character status. And I say that because, you know, Bond has faltered with Spectre, and then also Jack Bauer is being replaced. All the other JBs are currently out of commission. So I think that it's time for this JB to maybe become the number one JB. All right, so let's get started. A lot of people, I've seen some people say, well, where's Alicia Vikander? She's in this movie. Riz Ahmed also is in this film. But I think that the whole point of this spot is the return of Jason Bourne. That's why the movie's called Jason Bourne. So there's no mistake about it. You know, no Bourne legacy, just the only Bourne that counts, Jason. Although I saw somebody tweet, and it was very clever, they said, I kind of wish it had been called Bourne Again. And I was like, oh, that's a good one. That's a very good title. That would have been keeping more in line with the franchise to date. But I think that the Jason Bourne title, there's a really specific reason that I think that it's called that. So anyway, let's get started. Lots to discuss. All right, now here, he's, it would be great during this fight sequence if, look at that, just the raw power, that's really impressive. But Daniel Craig and Wolverine, this was like Find Yourself Fight Club, right? So I think that, you know, it fits very well within the mythology of film telling, you know, the film teller's language. But so he's clearly finding himself the hard way. But, you know, you'll see a very interesting, I'm trying to decide what the nationality of a lot of these locales are. I'm thinking Greece. I know the film was partially shot in Greece. We'll discuss that more momentarily as we get to some of the other shots. But it's definitely, I believe, at least somewhere like Eastern Europe, or like basically Eastern Europe and the Middle East meet, which of course is a, you know, powder keg right now with not only, you know, those two regions and what's going on with Syria and ISIS, but also, of course, economic problems in Greece. And then I read CNN. So proud of myself. I know all this. And then also the refugee crisis, of course, goes right through there. So very interesting. Like, really, if you're going to pick a place in the world to be, this is a good place to put Jason Bourne. All right. So he's in an underground fight. Now there's the, you know. Now that's great. That's an amazing shot. I'm curious to see how this plays out. This doesn't have like the real world documentary kinetic feel that Paul Greengrass's films usually do. In fact, I had to double check to make sure he was still the director. So it looks like he's upping his game a little bit. This almost looks like it's moving a little bit into like Michael Bay's 13 Hours territory. A little crisper, a little flashier, a little glitzier. And I think that'll be very interesting to see Paul Greengrass maybe evolve a little bit as a filmmaker in a more commercial direction. But I think on the other hand, though, you know, don't count out Paul Greengrass's more ripped from the headlines tendencies, because that looks like a really good HD above ground photo, you know, helicopter photo or drone photo of urban warfare. And I think that's fascinating. You're going to see a couple of shots about this. And I think that to put Jason Bourne in the middle of this, I'm already very curious as to why he's in the middle of a riot in the street. the riot in the streets. Okay, so very, very cool. His name, you know his name. That's great. And then you have this great, so he seems to be like here on some kind of like, I just love this. Like, there's a very much like, you can feel, even though there's literally nobody else in this frame but him in terms of like life, you feel that he's just on the outskirts of the action. So I think that's really fascinating. I couldn't quite tell what kind of motorcycle this is because I'm not sure. I don't think it's a police scooter because there's no sirens on it, but it does have that nifty little luggage case in the back there, which maybe is high holding this weapon that he uses. Okay, now you can see here, and he means business. That's some major firepower there. But you can see this is a scenario which we're very used to seeing these days. Not so much in a movie like this, but we're used to seeing it on the news. You know, there you have like a wall that looks like some sort of embassy or government building. Then you have protesters in the streets. And the fact that this action sequence is going to play out amongst that, I find really fascinating. And also, that's such a great setup that the CIA, of course, would be covering this and they'd be surveying the crowd. And all of a sudden, as you're about to see, they're like, holy crap, that's Jason Bourne. So, I mean, that's great. I like the CIA had the same reaction that the audience does. Okay, so moving on. Now that guy notices him, that's great. And you can see, this is, I love this. You know, this should be the shot-by-shot analysis board, right? I wish I had the CIA's budget. And I love the different shots of the crowd going on here. And then right in the middle, and he getting glorious color, Jason Bourne. All right, so, and it looks like he knows he's been spotted. Now, interestingly enough, these offices are, you're blinded by this light off that building, but you can, once you look past that, you know, there's no telltale the eye, but this is the London skyline. And London, of course, is our partner in a lot of the spying that we do militarily and, you know, sometimes, you know, has been exposed on a number of our own citizens in both countries. And it's something that even was explored in Spectre. So it's interesting, you know, for our partner across the pond to get themselves in Jason Bourne's crosshairs. Maybe they feel they've done enough with New York City. I recently watched The Bourne Supremacy again to get ready for this movie, and so maybe they've decided to take it to another, which has closed circuit cameras, by the way. I mean, London is the town for surveillance. If you're going to pick a place on the face of the earth that is like just blanketed in surveillance, it's London. So why would Jason Bourne go in there? We shall find out. All right, so this summer, I like that. They didn't put the other people in, like Alicia Vikander and Riz Ahmed. That's new talent. But you put Tommy Lee Jones in there because The Fugitive, you know, he's, you know, and also because you don't have Joan Allen, you don't have David Strathairn. I don't see Albert Finney here, who, of course, was in Bourne Supremacy. So this is your new, you know, gravitas actor. So, okay, let's see here. So he's like, why would he come up now? Good question. I love these fight sequences. That right there, that's the hallmark of one of the hallmarks of the Bourne franchise. Just raw power, breaking down the environment, using things. Like, I love it. It's a little MacGyver-y. I like that quite a bit. And what's great here, I also like, is that, you know, these are wide shots. You know, recently when I was watching the latest Taken, I was like, I can't see anything. The camera's too close. Liam Neeson, are you even doing these fight sequences? So I'm really glad to see, Matt Damon being, as he always has, but maybe even taking it to another level with, wide shot fight choreography and just giving us a great show. I love the fight sequences in the Bourne movies. It's one of my favorite aspects of the franchise. All right, now here, clearly one of the things that they have shot the most of and that looks most ready to go is this riot sequence, because you're seeing it interspersed throughout the trailer. Now this is great. See right there, that's fantastic. That is like, whoa, Jason Bourne is not playing around. I saw a funny article recently that said resting bitch face is like a real thing now. Like, computers can recognize it. And it's just like, just showing that you're like really in a bad mood and upset. And like, it's just like, and it's not going away. And so Jason Bourne, I think, has a resting bitch face here. I think that's fantastic. I've never seen him look so upset. I guess he's finally, as he said, he's remembered everything. So he's like, boy, do I have a laundry list of things that I'm ticked off about. So that's great. I love it. No, that's really great. I like that coming full circle from the very first Bourne movie. It's been a while. That's great. That's just the power of this franchise. Oh, and look, it's all the different photos from the different movies. I think that's fantastic. All right. Now, see, this is very interesting. I wonder what's going on in this sequence. Is he going to visit, like, some underground fighters? Is he crossing borders with refugees? Both Matt Damon and Paul Greengrass are very politically and socially aware. So I wouldn't be surprised if these real-world things got into this installment of the franchise. And I would like it, because as many of you know, I love that kind of stuff too. So I'm excited to see how they incorporate that. And look, us. So ripped, man. So ripped. I think a lot of people will be Googling Matt Damon Bourne workout or Bourne 5 workout. Because every time I go to look up pictures of people like Henry Cavill and stuff like that, for instance, he's a big one. There's always like, what's like the most search is like workout. And so I think Matt Damon will be joining that googly search as well. I have a little bit of Zoolander on the brain too, getting ready for that movie. Now there, that's Julius Stiles, I think. Yeah, Julius Stiles. In the crowd! All right, I think it's great they brought her back, and I think that's to further, anchor this to the previous films. That's one of the reasons I think she makes this first spot. Now this is great. Also, that shot is so freaking clear. I feel like I'm looking at a live HD camera of Vegas. That's amazing. I love that. And I love having Jason Bourne in Vegas. You know, you're going from like Greece and these refugee riots in the streets. They're actually having riots right now, actually in Greece right now over, you know, problems with like, I believe the pension changes to the pension plan in the country, but to like the glitz and glamour of Vegas with those gorgeous palm trees there. I mean, I love it, but yeah, it still seems very real world. Now this is an amazing sequence. Look at that. Look at these cars flip. Oh, I love it. That's amazing. Let's watch it again. It's so good. Oh, wow. Right in front of the Bellagio. Although, you know, talk about right from the headlines, some people recently shot in front of the Bellagio. So, wow. But look at that. Wow. The hydraulics flipping those cars up. That must have been so cool to see them shoot that. That's so great. Now, here's your big thing. Now, this is actually, you see him wrapping his hands here. That was the very first picture released for the film. So I think that's very fitting that it made the first spot to reference that. And that here. Look, like, so this is some kind of fight on the road, you know, maybe when he was just walking along, like, maybe, like, this is a pit stop. He's in a lot of fights. I'm curious to know why he's in fights in, you know, different locations, right? But this is not a very long one, right? You almost didn't even need to, like, take your shirt off and get all ready for this, right? So, there you go. Bam! Oh, that's great. Wow, the power of that hook. Ooh, and just look how... You know, a lot of times, you know, I was reading a really interesting article, actually, about... how people for the Warner Brothers movies, Zack Snyder movies, you know, they work with one trainer who Zack Snyder is like his guy, and he works on all the movies. It's in the current Vanity Fair if you want to read it. And he talks about how he has this regimen where for the actors, it's a trick where they actually make them lose like a ton of weight and they just leave the muscle and then they heighten it with like computer special visual effects. And that's why everybody like in 300 and stuff looks so big. But I think Matt Damon might actually be that big, which is awesome. I think that's so cool. I mean, he's not just muscular, but he looks like if he was coming toward you, you'd be like, yeah, you don't have to prove that you can knock me out in one punch. I surrender. I give up. Maybe the other movies coming out will do the same thing. So that's great. And that's just like a boss. Ooh, so good. And then there, more resting bitch face. That's fantastic. He is really ticked off. I feel bad for any CIA people who get in his way. You know, before, I guess that's an interesting evolution for the character. Before, he was like, who am I? I'm confused. I'm lost. I'm not sure who I am. You know, I'm going to give everyone the benefit of the doubt. I guess that's what it is. But no longer does he seem to give anyone the benefit of the doubt, even the dudes in the ring. So fascinating. Very interested to see how this develops. So, and then Jason Bourne, and then that's the name, because you know his name, there's nothing else to call this, it's Jason Bourne, he's taking his franchise back, and I think we all couldn't be happier. So that's my shot-by-shot analysis of the Jason Bourne Super Bowl spot. I think we can expect a trailer for this very soon, and I'm very, very excited. I look forward to hearing your thoughts down below. Thank you so much for tuning in, and you can check out some other episodes, including more Super Bowl coverage, right now.